What is going on, viewers? Welcome to the first episode of my Final Fantasy 15 walkthrough. I finally got a chance to sit down and play and enjoy this game, and I honestly hope that you end up enjoying it too. If you're excited to finally see this gameplay, please hug that like button with your cursor or your finger right now so you don't forget to do so later. Now, before I begin the story, I want to clue you in on a few things and sort of give you a heads up. All of these videos in the series are basically going to be on the longer side, 30 minutes at the minimum, pretty much. So you might want to save these episodes for days where you have a decent amount of free time. But that's because I don't know how long the story is going to be, so I honestly don't want the episodes to end up being too short. I'm going to be playing the game on easy, by the way. Which brings me to my next point. I did already play the tutorial for this, so I can have an idea of what to do, and I actually went a few minutes into the story, just a few minutes, so I can get a feel for things to make this video more exciting for you. But from about maybe halfway or so through this video, on throughout the whole rest of the game, you and I will be experiencing it together. So everything I'll be seeing for the first time, you'll be seeing for the first time, and I think that should keep things interesting. No, I don't want to do this tutorial. Yes, I am ready to kick some things off. This thing, specifically. I'm going to start this video off in awkwardness as I try to read this in a very epic fashion. Let me know what you think in the comments. Final Fantasy 15. In a time unknown, only a prophecy keeps hope alive in people's hearts. When darkness veils the world, the King of Light shall come. Now four brave warriors begin their journey, prepared to fight. What awaits the four, however, they do not know. Yes? No?
Was that fire or not? Or not?
The tale of the chosen king, savior to the star. Oh, I also want to mention that because I want this to sort of feel almost like a movie, during actual cutscenes, I'm probably going to try to avoid speaking, but during the in-between gameplay, I'm probably going to, you know, speak as much as I can, or speak far more often at least, so that, you know, I keep you engaged and entertained. But yes, this is Noctis, main character of the game, and as you can see, things start off in a very intense fashion.
Hang in there,
Prompto.
Stay down. We'll keep him busy.
Ignis.
Quickly, before he strikes again!
Here comes!
Gladiolus.
I got your back!
Here you go.
Let's do it.
Let's go!
JK, I think that's just like a preview for what's gonna happen toward the end of the game. Before the fall. Cutscene time. I'm gonna shut up now and you'll see exactly what I was talking about. Final Fantasy's cutscenes are beautiful. Please enjoy.
The decreed hour is come. Set forth with my blessing, Prince Noctis.
Thank you, Your Majesty.
Take your leave and go in the grace of the gods.
Right.
Well, princes will be princes.
So much for royal protocol.
Not like you had to deliver a formal address.
Your Highness!
What now?
I fear I have left too much unsaid. You place a great burden on those who would bear with you.
You're one to talk.
I ask not that you guide my wayward son, merely that you remain at his side.
Indeed, Your Grace.
We'll see the prince to Altissia if it's the last thing we see.
Yeah, what he said. Hate to break this up, but Kor's got the motor running. Drados, he's in your hands.
And another thing. Do mind your manners around your charming bride-to-be.
Your Majesty as well. Try to mind yours around our esteemed guests from Niflheim.
You have no cause for concern.
Nor do you.
Take heed. Once you set forth, you cannot turn back.
You think I would?
I need only know that you are ready to leave home behind.
Don't know about you, but I'm ready as I'll ever be.
Take care on the long road. Wheresoever you should go, the line of Lucis goes with you. Walk tall, my son.
Come on! Them graphics, though! Did you see his mustache hairs, the beard hairs? Yo, I've always loved that about Final Fantasy, but please be warned, gameplay graphics will not be as good. But hey, make sure to look forward to cutscenes. Oh, another thing I want to warn you about. They have a bunch of weird or difficult to pronounce words in this game, and I'm going to be reading a lot, so if I butcher a lot of words, yeah, try not to hate me. I'll do my best. Chapter 1, Departure. Prince Noctis, Lucis Calum, sets forth from his homeland with his three-man retinue in tow. His destination, Altissia, capital of Acardo, where he will formalize the union of states through his marriage to Lady Luna Freya of the Imperial Province of Tenebrae. Now, if I messed up any part of that, please let me know in the comments. I don't know, I think I pronounced everything properly, but I might have to go back and repronounce some things. And I feel strange too, because I'm pretty sure I just heard the old man say that L word, Noctis's last or middle name, whatever that is, Lucis, or Lou, I don't know how he pronounced it, and I feel bad, I'm butchering it already. But I'm also stalling for time while Final Fantasy takes a year and a half to load, which hopefully it won't do very often. But let's go! I'm in it! Finally playing Final Fantasy and it's in modern day, somewhat. I'm kind of confused. Maybe it's not a modern day because, I mean, they have cars and whatnot, but there's always that classical, not classical, that Renaissance-y before an era sort of feel. I don't know how to describe it. That's a sweet car, though.
About hitching our way there. Thought people were friendly outside the city.
Yeah, you can only go so far on the kindness of strangers.
You're just gonna have to push her all the way.
I've already pushed myself.
Push!
To the brink of death.
So dramatic.
Come on, car isn't gonna move itself.
Sheesh.
Sheesh!
I thought the car was supposed to move us.
Wouldn't that be nice?
Can it? Ready, steady.
Push! Don't push something so heavy.
I can actually steer the car, which is kind of sweet. This is how I drive in real life. Swerve? Alright, well, not this slow, obviously. I wonder what would happen if I do this, though. Will they say anything?
Unbelievable.
Not exactly a fairy tale beginning, huh, Prince Noctis?
We let ourselves get carried away.
No, car's coming. Let me push it back. I don't want to get hit. Go back. Go. No, move.
Let's just hope this isn't some omen.
Gladio, do me a favor.
What?
Push this thing by yourself.
All Gladio. By
you won't even notice if we just let go.
Prompto, don't even think about it.
Save some breath for pushing.
Ignis, come on, time to switch.
Nuh-uh, we just switched back there.
And it's my turn, Noct.
His turn.
My hands are killing me.
You rather I kill you with mine?
Easy there, tough guy.
Any luck?
Only a busy signal.
Hold the phone. Is it just me? Or was it supposed to be way closer?
I assure you, the map is correct.
The map said Hammerhead was right there.
Literally, next door.
Looks that way, on a map of the world.
Oh, car's coming up. Now they have to wait.
The world's a big old place,
filled with wonders.
Tell that to my legs.
You guys even pushing?
Hard as I can.
But the music, though. Final Fantasy 15. Sorry, and I was talking originally there, but I realized I was talking over the characters a lot, so I'm like, alright, let me just kind of quiet down. Then I'm like, you know what, it's getting kind of boring looking at this one camera angle, so let me turn it a little bit. But anyway, I definitely still have a long way to go when it comes to making the videos more entertaining and whatnot. But definitely bear with me. Once again, let me know what you think in the comments. If you disagree with me, if you think I'm doing fine, let me know. If I could use some work, you can be honest about it. I'll get there, though. Hammerhead, Outpost.
Hey there, y'all kept a girl waiting. Now, which one's the prince?
Now, I can't lie, I'm not sure how I feel about the fact that the first girl they show is dressed like that.
Not Hitch just yet.
Lady Lunafreya's groom-to-be, here in Hammerhead.
Apologies for taking so long.
You best save your apologies for Pawpaw.
Well, that makes you...
Very country.
Cindy. Sid's grease monkey granddaughter.
Cindy.
Roll her in while I'm still young.
I think that's how you pronounce it.
Didn't your daddy tell you? She's a custom classic, not some beat-up old clunker.
Sid, Prince Sophia.
Yeah.
Prince. Like they took your old man and kicked the dignity out of him.
What?
Well, damn.
You got a long way to go, son. And that slack jaw's getting you nowhere fast.
Come on, yo, that car is heat.
She's gonna take a while. Y'all get her in and run along.
Y'all heard him. Let's get moving. Right this way.
Push! Push!
Now we play the waiting game.
Never liked that game.
Never any good at it either.
Nah, I definitely know what they mean. I'm not the most patient person. Is my boy Noctis wearing joggers, though? Yo! Nah, I don't know. First things first. Speak. I said speak, not jump. A little close. Personal space, Noctis. Come on, dude.
Y'all ain't never been out this way before, have you? Go on, have a look around. This'll make sure y'all don't get lost.
World map. Thank you. I like her hair. Her hair looks pretty sweet. Visit the local tipster to gather information.
Might as well make good use of the extra time.
Main character's hair is pretty sweet, too. What's this? Refuel? Oh, wow. Can actually restock on gas in this game. That's kind of cool. I kind of want to learn to walk, though, instead of sprinting around everywhere. It's kind of awkward. What's this?
Whoa! They got Ebony out here. Oh, Ignis is gonna flip.
Wait, what's a gill?
Well, Ignis. Earn gill by completing hunts or by selling trinkets you find. So money, basically. And I have zero? When you broke as a joke?
A moment.
Never mind.
We've expended the last of our funds on the repairs.
You wanna tell me that now?
We confer with Cindy.
Broken down and flat broke.
Adding insult to injury.
The Pauper Prince, level 1. Select. Accepted.
Old man's in for both after charging us that much.
Yeah, let's pay him a visit.
But that walk, though. And the Pauper Prince, I have mixed feelings about that. It's kind of contradictory, but it's kind of like... It's kind of like a cool duality, too. I like it. Sort of. Maybe. Personal space still, Noctis. Come on, dude.
She ain't gonna be ready for a while. Y'all need something?
Can you give me some money, please? Ask for a discount. Ask my friends. Ask for a loan.
Hate to ask, but could we borrow some cash?
Oh, now I get it. This must be what Papa meant when he said he was gonna teach them boys a lesson. told me he ought to have y'all take care of some ornery varmints that have been causing a ruckus.
Ornery, wow.
I'd be happy to pay y'all for your services if you're up to the challenge.
Got the character down. And I'm definitely down for the challenge, of course. Plan,
I say we play along and teach him not to underestimate us.
True. You earn 10 AP. Spend ability points to power up Noctis and his friends. Acquire new abilities on the Astral Sphere from the Ascension menu. Ascension. Use ability points to activate nodes on the Astral Sphere. Yada yada. Blah blah blah. Nobody likes reading stuff. Alright. Air Step. Use L and Circle to take a step in mid-air after attacking with a sword or polearm. Wow, that sounds kind of sweet. Boots damage dealt with unscathed during boost damage dealt when unscathed during chain attacks. Sorry, that makes sense. Phase through an enemy's attack without using MP by pressing square at the last second. That's cool. And reduce the cost of phasing. Activate this ability for 8 AP. I'll be broke as a joke after that. What about this one? For 6 AP, you can take a step in midair. I'll start off with this one. This is pretty sweet looking, by the way. Oh, there's more over here. Are these different? Down hammer. Anyway, I'll definitely get more into this later on, but so I'm gonna start for
but
now.
Don't go running around after dark. The demons are liable to rip y'all to shreds.
Demons?
Here. This ought to be enough for a place to stay.
Hey, just we got money.
Us, though, don't tell Papa.
Hey, we ain't broke no more. Alright, let's go. Got a job to do. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, you know the rule, the law. Everything look both ways before crossing the street. Yep. Because if I didn't look, I would have probably got hit by that car. Apparently, we run pretty quickly, although awkwardly.
Looks like we found our first targets.
Oh, I can point warp. The threat meter displays when an enemy detects your presence. Point warp.
Heads up.
Oh, that's pretty sweet. Conjure weapons to attack. Yeah, I know how it works. And I do think that's pretty sweet. Let me move.
You've got all those arms at your disposal. Use them.
Immaculate. We're on the same page. Yeah.
So what's cool to me in this game, from what I've seen at least, is that they don't carry weapons around, they conjure them just before they use them. And I think that's so sweet. Probably not an original idea, but I think it's pretty sweet.
On we go.
Report card, A, B, and A+, I will take it. Which way am I going? I wonder if there's a way I can sprint, though. What does this button do? Oh, holding square is how I walk. That's kind of cool. Oh, holding circle is how I sprint. That's sweet. What does the triangle do? I don't even know. Ooh. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. That was kind of... Wow! Hold up. Oh, come on! Anyway, let me get there. No music. Do not get all gentle. We got more fighting to do.
They aren't gonna know what hit 'em. Let's do this.
Speaking of which, warp strike. Press square to roll dodge to deftly evade enemy attacks. Hold square to defend against oncoming attacks. Alright. Holding square. Point warp.
The best offense.
Oh, I didn't mean to hold that. Cancel. Warp strike is so sweet to me. Oh, I got hit, damn it.
Yep, right, got it.
Rip! Combo attacks! Whew, that was sweet. No! No! Oh, I'm getting worked up! Why me? That's so sweet. Alright, let me try that heavy weapon. Eat this! That damage though. Oh, can I hit my allies? He said watch where you swing that thing, so I kind of feel like I Might have stabbed somebody. Or slashed somebody. Stab. That's the word I was looking for.
We'll be done in no time.
Oh, finesse D? Well, damn! It's a hell of a downgrade. Sprint. Can I jump further? Hoop! Hop!
So, where are we headed anyway?
Nowhere until the repairs are done. Then we head for Golden Key.
By the way,
that, we hop a boat, and before you know it, lover boy's hitched.
Wait for car repairs, then wedding bells in the air.
Oh, gosh. But I was gonna say, I don't actually make those jumping noises in real life when I jump. But I might, though. Hoop! Hop!
Almost there. Give it your all.
Alright. Oh, yeah, I can do, like, group attacks or whatever. I think it has to charge first, though. Noctis can instantly warp strike. Yeah, I know. Warp strike. Combo. Weapon switch. Success. That combo, though. The weapon switch combo was nice. Switch again. Money. Ooh. Oh, that was so sweet.
I think I could handle this all by myself.
Oh, I got stabbed, damn it. I gotta become better at dodging attacks.
Far less trouble than anticipated.
Smaller weapon. Combination. Smaller weapon. Switch it up on him. Money.
Nice.
Let's go. Alright. Brought finesse back up slightly. Time and offense. A plus. Phone call. Hold on.
Hello?
Hey, it's Cindy. How goes the hunting?
Actually, we just finished.
Look at his hair, yo. So sweet.
Only this time, it's for a person. Fella named Dave went off. We ain't heard from him since. Reckon he staked out a spot in an old shack nearby.
Old shack? Oh, got it. We'll take a look.
The cell phone, though. The smartphone, though. Alright, let's go check this place out.
So, what did Cindy say?
Needs us to find some Dave guy.
Hunter becomes the hunted. Head to the abandoned shack.
Said he's holed up in that shack.
Well, that kind of like gives away, well, not necessarily what's gonna happen, but the idea of this chapter, the title of it kind of gives it away. But cars driving by, that's so sweet. Excuse me, which one are you, Ignis? I'm gonna be all cool and walk toward it because I'm indoors now, and that's the proper thing to do. Psych!
This.
What is this? Mutant dual horn sighting. Codename Bloodhorn. Characteristics: red tusks, extremely violent. Outstanding bounty on saber tusks in the area. Oh yeah, I gotta read it in my epic voice. Whoa. That shot though, let's go.
We are now.
Spoke too soon.
I'm going all out. Oh, really? I got hit down already? I guess I gotta learn to block. Them dodges though, did you see that? He left like after images, that's so sweet.
Let's be done with this riffraff.
Okay, no finesse. I'm all messed up right now. Let me warp strike this tiny little distance. No, no! Oh, I couldn't dodge those, damn it. Get off me! Weapon switch! Although using a large weapon in tight space probably isn't the best idea. Looks like we're done already, though.
And on we go.
Right.
Hey, what about the shack over there?
What shack? What shack over where? Wait, how do you see that from inside? Oh, well. They do kind of have windows a little bit, sort of. Yeah, plausible. Maybe. Oh, can I jump, like, on stuff, I wonder? Hoop! It was worth a shot. Alright. Sprinting full tilt. Hoop! More scorpion things. Oh, no, no, no. These are like the dog things that just attacked me. What we were reading about. Warp up to the windmill?
Huh. What are we looking at?
This creature is known as a saber tusk.
Saber tusk. Friends propose strategies to gain an advantage in combat. Follow their strategies to earn AP. That sounds like good incentive. Blue markers indicate points you can warp to. I know how that works.
It skewers prey with its tusks, extracting game from the safety and comfort of burrows.
That's a bit heartless.
Oh, I don't think I did it right.
Don't think we'll be before.
But I can still warp. If I don't get eaten right now, what the hell? What the hell? I just want to do that. I like warping. I don't know why it's so sweet to me. Noctis will quickly recover HP and MP while hanging from high ground. Warp strike a distant enemy from this position and receive a damage boost. Let's do it. Strike. I love that combo. It's so sweet. Alright, I'm going to try to use, if I can hit this thing, try to use a teamwork combo. Let's go, Prompto. Piercer. Oh, I got a trophy. Brother in arms. Stop pushing Prompto, damn it. Messing up my camera angle. I think we're done here.
None the worse for that.
Finesse keeps going up and down. I gotta get better.
Who's out there?
Well, and look who's in here.
The hunter becomes the hunted.
Dave, right? Been looking for you.
Didn't mean to cause y'all any trouble. I've been stuck here on account of my sprained ankle. Yeah, something funny about them varmints. I gave them hell, but couldn't finish the job.
David Auburn.
Still one mean
I think.
About. Well, y'all don't look much like hunters, but what do you say?
I take that as an insult.
For me?
Have you seen my hair? No. Put the puppy to rest. I guess I can ask the crew.
Oh, sounds too dangerous to be let alone. Tell us where to go.
Alright, Ignis has decided. I think that was Ignis anyway. Magic flask. Times
one. People are at risk, Noct. You have a royal duty to ensure their safety.
I suppose. Ignis earned 150 XP. Or EXP. The Mutant Marauder. I see something on the ground. Pick this up. A debased coin. Times one. Locate the target, Mutant Marauder. Alright. Oh, I haven't made it this far into the game yet, so, yeah. Reactions will be more genuine than Ignis.
It would be wise to rest up before we set out.
A formidable foe awaits. Prepare for this encounter by resting at a nearby haven. Ignis will cook a status-boosting meal for the party. So, Ignis is the chef. That's pretty cool. It will be wise to rest up before we set out. Yeah, a good idea. Nah, I'm good. Hell nah, I'm good. I'm straight. I'm basically super not chill. Good idea.
In that case, let's find a spot to make camp.
The hunters,
I think that's
really
cool.
Out in full force around here, huh?
So they're the new Crown's Guard or something?
Similar, though technically a civilian outfit.
They've definitely seen a lot more action than we have.
Is it cool that we rock Crown's Guard outfits?
Be worse not to. They made them especially for us.
Even got a sweet insignia on them.
In the Crown's Guard, your attire identifies you. So wear it with pride.
The Crown's Guard. Merryroth Haven Campground. Feel free to correct me anytime. What's up with all the characters on the ground? Camp. I was about to step into the fire, too. What would you like to do? Camp? You can train? That's pretty sweet. I think I'll just camp for now, though.
I'll see what I can whip up.
Let's call it a day. I'm stepping all up in the fire. Merryroth Haven. 0 days elapsed. Oh, they actually build stuff. That's pretty sweet. Camping chairs, tents. Is that a camera? Yeah. Yo, I really think this is sweet. I don't know why I'm into like the simple things. Trying to decide where to place everything. It's the little things, Final Fantasy, except for your cutscenes. They are very big and huge and wonderful, and gifts from the gaming gods. Don't tell anyone I said that. Ignis uses ingredients to prepare meals at camp, acquire new recipes to expand Ignis's cookbook, and the variety of bonuses available. Attack boost, HP boost, attack boost level 3, and attack boost level 2 increases attack by 20, by 30. Then I'm guessing this is temporary, because it seems like cheating if we can just whip a food up that's going to make us stronger permanently. Look, you can even see, look at the chair. It says Coleman on it. You can see the company name on it. That's so sweet. It's the little things. This video is already 33 minutes. So I'm debating whether or not I should leave everyone in suspense and save the big battle for next video, or if I should end this video with that big battle. And I actually think it's gonna end up being the latter, because why not? It'd be a great way to end the first episode. Wait, does this really increase? Oh, Ignis, nice. It might actually increase it permanently. That would be sweet if it did. Prompto is documenting the journey in photographs. That's so sweet! Review the pictures he takes and save his best snapshots. Share snapshots shots on social... Is that a tongue twister? Share snapshots on social media and show your friends. That is kind of cool. Oh, really? That girly pose?
Perfect timing.
That was a pretty sweet one. Though I'm not sure how he would have taken that picture in the middle of the fight, unless he was chilling.
Hey, this one's pretty good.
Action shot.
I dig it too.
I kind of like this one. Do I want to share it right now, though? No, not really. Alright, what happens next? Saving. Access the pause menu outside of dungeons and combat to save manually. Note that certain quests may prohibit saving. Interesting. Tutorials offer a wealth of story and gameplay information. Take the time to review if you find yourself struggling in a battle.
Like a father to her.
Ever since they got back, Sid's been the only one looking after her.
Rather more than a middling mechanic can handle.
Can I jump off this?
Considered, I'd say she turned out okay.
Oh, nice. I rolled. Like any girl. Realistic.
You just need to treat her right.
Treat her wrong and Sid'll stuff his wrench where the sun don't shine.
Take care of the car.
Wow.
And it will take care of
us. Well, I mean, yeah, at least he's car. Didn't say it in a ruder way. The Three Valleys parking spot. Wow, that is a long ways away. You want to give me a car, a bike, or something, please? Why is he running like that? Looking at Ignis all sideways. Oh no, it's not as far as I thought it was. And apparently, I don't seem to be affected by stamina or... Wait, am I? I am. I think I am. I stopped sprinting for a while, but it may have been because of the camera angle.
Sometimes I wonder if we'll ever sit inside that beautiful car again.
Sitting most of the day was pretty nice.
Wow.
Even better.
Laziest thing I've ever heard from a group of adventurers in a video game. I approve. I definitely approve. Yes, I know this video is getting to be pretty long, so I'm hoping this fight doesn't last forever. It is definitely gonna last forever. Do you see that shit? Yep, I'm saving that for the next episode. Thank you so much. No, I'm just playing. I'll try to fight it. I was about to say, thanks for watching. Yada yada, blahzy blah. Hug that like button.
Wait a sec.
What? Scared, big guy?
You ought to be too. Things vicious.
You sure? Looks tame to me.
Yeah.
Look out!
Oh, shiznies. Oh, he seems to be capable.
It's not over yet.
This thing is huge.
Ready for round two?
Warp. Get me out of here. Your friends can perform techniques to aid you in combat. Yeah, I already started doing that. Warp back. Oh, I couldn't? Did it not really affect it? Let's see, Gladiolus. Gladio. Oh, he missed. No, not nice work. Bad work. You missed. Don't come after me. Warp. Warp. Let's go. Alright, I got him distracted, I think. Somewhat. Warp back. Money. Heavy weapon. Let's go. Or just knock me down. Okay. Warp strike. Wow. How am I not dead? How am I not dead? I wonder if I have any spells. He seems to want to focus on me. Come on. Yo, this thing has a lot of health. Alright, we gotta try some combos or something. I'm gonna try Piercer again. Let's go, Prompto. Don't die. Ooh, nice hit. Go, go, go. Let's go. Let's go. Money. Ooh. Still awful at dodging hits, as you can see. The Mutant Marauder. Let's go! We did it! Took it down.
Ring, ring.
Getting that phone call.
Hello?
Hey! Dave just called and said he's safe. Thanks for finding him.
Ken?
Nice work, y'all. By the way, the old girl's looking good as new. She'll be waiting at the garage.
Hey! Get our car back. Alrighty, I think that's gonna be it for now.
Who's up next behind the wheel?
Ignis should take it and never let go.
It helps that he can keep four eyes on the dash.
I couldn't even keep one.
Not sure I'd do any better.
Rip. In the driver's seat. Good. Because I need the leg room in back.
But yes, like I was saying before they rudely interrupted me, I think I'm gonna end this episode here. The game did just autosave. So, let me make sure I finish things properly. Yes, yes. If you have made it this far... Oh, what's this? HP. Oh, it was just like a little mini loading screen. Yes, a Final Fantasy for fans and first-timers. Anyway, if you watched this whole video all the way through, thank you so very much. I've never really tried to make this long a video before, especially as a series. I mean, I may have a few videos this long, but... asking people to, you know, to spend a few minutes of their time to watch my video is one thing, but this was approaching an hour, basically, you know. I mean, I know it's 40 minutes, still 20 minutes from an hour, but this was a good chunk of time. So honestly, if you watched this whole episode, thank you so, so much. And I hope you've enjoyed it up to this point. I'm definitely going to finish playing through this game. I'm going to keep recording it. I'm going to get this whole thing up on YouTube for you. And once again, you know, try to stick to watching it on days where you have a decent amount of free time, because... it's gonna be a while. But once again, thank you so very much for watching. Come back here next week for part two, the next episode. Hug that like button with your cursor or your finger. Join me in the shade if you're new to the channel. And share this video where you can. Please and thanks. Take it easy, alright? Later.